Welcome to the course of unix and shell programming. This course is for third btech first sem. Myself G Prashanti, Department of Information Technology, Vignans Lara, Institute of Technology and Science. So in today's course, in today's class, we are seeing we'll be going to go through what are unix components and some basic commands in unix. Okay, so our unix components were in previous class you have seen like what is kernel and shell. Okay, so unix components. Okay, so in unix we are consists of three main components. Okay, so here we are having three main components: kernel, shell, utilities. Okay, so for every unix we will be having this basic structure like hardware, so kernel, shell. So where kernel is said to be the heart of the operating system. Okay, so or we can say it is like the core of the operating system. Okay, so where here is a core of the unix system, since it is the core of the unix system, so at the boot up only. Okay, while the system is being booted only, then only the kernel will be loaded into the memory. Okay, memory means in the RAM, random access memory. So in the RAM the kernel will be stored. Okay, and this kernel is like manages the entire resources. What are your resources? The resources are like your CPU, whatever the CPU you are having, whatever the IO devices you are having, or you can say whatever the memory you are having. Okay, so your IO devices, so memory. So all these comes under and similarly your process, all these comes under the resources. Okay, so and what is the kernel will be doing? It acts as a manager of these resources, like it will be doing process management. So since we are saying Unix is a multi-user, multi-tasking operating system, so if it has to support multi-user, it has to support multitasking also. Okay, where tasks are nothing but the process, which process has to go for execution, which process has to be waited. Okay, that process management is done by the kernel itself. Okay, similarly it will be doing the memory management also, where in the memory management which part of the memory has to be allocated to which process, and which part of the memory has to be deallocated. Okay, so it will be managing the entire memory. Okay, and similarly CPU, so which process has to go for execution. Okay, so that the CPU should not sit idle, so that CPU the throughput is, so that the throughput is more, the CPU has to be the CPU should not sit idle. Okay, so for that the CPU management, the CPU management is also done by the kernel. And similarly for the IO devices, IO means that printers. Okay, so all that resources are managed by the kernel. Okay, so here kernel manages the resources like process management, memory management, and CPU scheduling, process scheduling, which process has to be scheduled to the CPU, and similarly for IO devices. Okay, so it acts as a manager of all these resources. Okay, so that is the kernel, and similarly we are having the shell also. Okay, so here the shell acts as an interface. Okay, so if you see here, the shell acts as an interface between the user and the kernel. Okay, the shell acts as an interface between the user and the kernel, and it is said to be a command interpreter. Okay, whatever the command you are giving on the shell, so it interprets that command, means that it converts that command into the assembly language. Okay, after converting into assembly language, it hands over to the kernel. So the kernel will execute it, and it will be displaying the result. Okay, so when you enter into your Unix system, you will be residing on this shell. Okay, so here the shell is said to be a command interpreter. It takes each command. Okay, whatever the, when you enter into your Unix system, you will be placed into the shell. Okay, so when you enter in the Unix system, you will be placed into the shell, where in the shell you will be giving the commands. Whatever the task you want to do, the task you have to say in the form of command on the shell. For example, if you want to open a file, then you have to use the cat command. Cat, and then you have to say the file name. Okay, if you want to create the file, okay, you have to say cat greater symbol file name. So for creating a file, okay. So in that way, you will be giving a command here. Okay, in the shell, you will be giving a command, and when you, after giving the command, when you say enter, okay, when you say enter, so the shell starts interpreting that command. Okay, so means that it will be converting that command into the assembly language, and then after converting into assembly language, it passes to the operating system kernel. Okay, it passes to the kernel, where the kernel start execution of the command, and it will be displaying the result on the monitor. Okay, so that is about the shell, and here we are having several types of shells. Okay, so and in previous class you have seen several types of shells, like your bash shell, conch shell, C shell. Okay, so different types of shells that are available. So you will be having like bourne shell, which is represented by sh, C shell, conch shell, bonnie again shell, also said to be bash shell. Okay, so these are the commonly available shells, and we have gone through them. Okay, so I will give a brief comparison of these four shells. Okay, so where here the bourne shell, so this is the first original Unix shell that we are having. So here for that shell, the path is /bin/sh. Okay, and the default prompt, non-root user means that he is a normal user, since Unix is multi-user. Okay, since it is like multi-user, since we are having multiple users operating, like user 1, user 2, user 3, multiple users. Okay, so for that user 1, user 2, user 3, for all those multiple users, the default prompt for the shell is $symbol. Okay, so if it is like root user means that he is an administrator, or you can say he is a super admin. Okay, so for this root user, the default prompt will be #symbol. Okay, so these are like categorized to know who is working. Okay, if a normal user is working on the shell, if the administrator is working on the shell, so that we can know by using this prompt. Okay, so if the shell is running with the #prompt, that means that the super user is working on it. Okay, so means that the admin is working on the shell. Okay, so if the history is with $symbol, if the shell is running with some $symbol, that means that some normal user is working on the shell. Okay, so to categorize those root user and normal user, we are having two different prompts. Okay, so $and #, where for bash shell the $ represents the non-root user, that is the normal user, and the #  represents the root user. Okay, so and the C shell, coming to the C shell, so here the path for the C shell is /bin/csh. Okay, and similarly the default for normal users, the default prompt will be %, and for the root user will be the hash only. Okay, and for the conch shell, so similarly for the conch shell also, so it is like /bin/ksh. Okay, conch shell. So here also the default prompt is $and #. Okay, so and similarly coming to the bourne again shell, so here it is like /bin/bash, and coming to the root user, bash x.xx, where this x represents the version number, like 3.50. okay, which version you are using, that has to be represented in x. Okay, and similarly the default prompt will also be bash x.xx x#. Okay, x.xx#. Okay, x.xx, $ for the normal. Okay, so these are the some comparisons, important comparisons of the four shells: bone shell, seashell, conch shell, and bonnet shell. Okay, so coming to this class, what are utilities? So up till now, we have seen that three components of Unix. First one, we have seen about the kernel, where kernel is said to be the heart of the operating system or core of the operating system, where it is doing all the basic services that an operating system do, such as process management, okay, CPU process scheduling, and similarly memory management, I/O management, okay, all those things, all those managing of the resources are done by the kernel itself. Okay, so second one comes the shell. Okay, where shell acts as an interface between the user and the kernel. Okay, when the user logs in, he will be placed into the shell. Okay, so when the user logs into the Unix system, he will be placed in the shell. So where from that shell he will be giving some commands to perform his tasks. Okay, after giving the commands, the shell will be converting into assembly language and passes it to the kernel. Okay, and passes it to the kernel, where the kernel will be executing and displaying it. Okay, so the third one is your utilities. Okay, so the third one is your utilities. Okay, so here utilities are nothing but the commands. Okay, what are the commands that are available on Unix? Those are said to be the utilities. Even your shell program. Okay, so even your shell program is said to be the utility, and all these utilities resides on the secondary disk. Okay, so all these utilities resides in the secondary disk. And whenever the user executes, whenever the user gives a command, okay, so whenever the user uses any command, then only those commands will be going into the RAM. Okay, then only those commands will be brought into the memory from the hard disk. Okay, so that is about the Unix, where in Unix we will be having several hundred utilities, and these utilities resides on the secondary disk. Okay, so and whenever whatever the command that is required, okay, whenever whatever the command that is required, that command only will be taken into the memory. Okay, so utilities are often referred to as commands. Okay, so these commands consist some accomplish universal functions. Okay, it consists of some commands that accomplish universal functions. Universal functions like we are having like date, okay. So you will be having some date, calendar, who. So these are like universal function. Anybody can use them. Okay. So similarly, we are having some function related to editing. Okay. So if you give like some command while writing the commands, if you give any spelling mistake like that, so you can edit it. Okay, so spelling mistake, some syntax mistakes, if you are giving like that, by using delete spaces like that, so you can edit those commands. Okay, so and similarly, we are having file maintenance, where we are having several commands like mkdir for creating a directory, cd for changing the directory. And similarly, for creating files, we are having cat command. Okay, so for displaying files, for changing the ownership of the file. Okay, so for changing the ownerships of the file, for changing the permissions of a file, for all these we are having some utilities, and all those utilities comes under the file maintenance. Okay, so similarly for printing also, we are having a command pr. So by using that command, we can view the print option. Okay, and similarly for sorting also, if you want, you can sort also. Okay, from A to Z, from 1 to 100, whatever, from Z to A. So sorting, it provides commands for sorting also. Okay, and the programming support, so you can write shell scripts. Okay, so we can write shell script for performing various where you can create your own functions. Okay, not only built-in functions, here we can create the user-defined functions. Okay, so by using that functions, we can perform different tasks of the user. Okay, so that programming support is also provided by the shell. Okay, so the utilities consist of different like universal functions that can be used by any users, and we are having some editing commands. Okay, so by using that commands, you can edit the commands that you have given. If you are, while typing the command, if you are having any spelling mistake while typing the command, if you are given any syntax error, so by using that editing commands, we can edit the commands. Okay, so file maintenance, so we are having several utilities. So like mkdir for changing the ownership of the file, for giving the permissions to the file. Okay, we are having several file maintenance utilities. Similarly for printing also, to give the print, we are having the command. By using that command, we can give the printing. And similarly sorting, so if you want to sort a file with from A to Z letters, or if you want to sort from Z to A. Okay, so if you want to sort by numbers, okay, so that sorting, for doing that sorting also, several we are having sort commands with several options. Okay, so by using sort commands with different options, you can sort the contents of the file. Okay, so programming support, where in the programming support it will be provided, we can write shell scripts. Okay, we can write shell scripts, we can define our own functions by using for loops, if loops. Okay, so while loops, we can, all those are supported by the unix. Okay, by using for, while, if loops, we can write the programs also. Okay, so that is about the utilities. Okay, so that is about the unix components, where we have seen like what is kernel, what is shell, and what are utilities. So now coming to the commands. So we are going to study some basic Unix commands. Okay, or we'll be saying like utilities, some basic utilities. Okay, Unix has a large family of powerful commands. We are having 100 number of commands here. Okay, so for file maintenance, for editing, okay, for like sorting, so for different tasks. For different tasks for the user to perform, so several utilities have been provided here. Okay, so some major commands are, so here some we have given some example of some major commands like cat. Okay, so cat for creating the file, we can create the file by using the cat command. Date, okay, to note today's date and time, we can use the date command. Similarly mkdir for creating a directory. Okay, if you want to create a directory and store files in it, we can create a directory by using the mkdir. Similarly cd for changing the directory. If you want to move from one directory to another directory, you can change from one directory to another directory by using the cd command. Okay, so similarly you will be having pwt, where pwt is the present working directory. If you want to know what is the present working directory, okay, then you have to give the pwd. When you say pwd, so the current directory that you are working with, that will be displayed. Okay, so similarly remove directory, for deleting any directory we are having rmdir. Okay, similarly we are having ls. Okay, where ls for listing all the files that are stored in the Unix, okay, that are stored in the directory. Okay, so if you are going to any particular directory and you want to see all the files that are stored in the directory, then you have to say ls command. Okay, by using that ls command, the shell will be listing all the files that are stored in that directory. Okay, so similarly you are having cp command, so copy command. Okay, so if you want to copy from one file to another file, then you can use the cp command. Okay, so move command is like your cut and paste. Okay, so if you want to remove the data from the source file and it has to be stored in another file, okay, So then you can use the MV command. MV command is like cut and paste in your Word document. Okay. Similarly, RM command to remove a file. Okay. So to delete any file, we are having the command called as the RM. Okay. Similarly, we are having a cat command again to display the contents of the file. Okay. So and CA, it is like calendar. If you want to have the calendar for this month, then you are having CAL command. Okay, so by using that CAL, we can get the calendar for the entire year also. Okay, and similarly, who command. Okay, so who command is used, who is working. If you want to know who is working, so by using the who command, all the users that are working at that particular time, that will be displayed. Okay, so in that way, we are having several commands that are available. So for clearing the screen, you are having clear. Okay, so and different commands, chmod, chown. Okay, so for changing the permissions to the file, for changing the ownership to the files. Okay, so all these are the different commands that we are having. Okay, so let's see some basic commands here. So here in this class, the first command that we are going through is the CAL. CAL is the calendar. Okay. So this command will print a calendar for a specified month or year. Okay. So to show this a month's calendar. So here the syntax for this calendar is you have to give the command CAL, and then if you want the month, you can give the month, and if you want the year, you can give the year. Okay. So these are the options. Like when you give CAL on the on your prompt, it shows the current month calendar on the terminal. Okay, so for example, this is your prompt. Okay, this is the prompt. Okay, where you have given CAL. When you give CAL, so whatever this month, August. Okay, so this is the August month of 2020. It will be showing August 2020 and this month's calendar. Okay, so if you want to view any month and year, then you have to say month and year. Okay. If you don't, these are like options. Okay. If you don't give like options, then directly it will be displaying current month calendar. Okay. If you want to see particular month and particular year, then here are the options you have to. Okay. So like here, I have given like CAL 6th. I want to view for the 6th month for the year 1970. Okay. I want to view a 1976 month, then I have to say CAL 6 1970. Okay, so and then it will be displaying June 1970 calendar. So month of that June 1970 calendar will be displayed. Okay, so it shows the calendar of selected month and year. Okay, where you have to give the month and year option. If you give the month and year option, whatever the selected month and year, for that month and year, the calendar will be displayed. Okay. So that is about the first one, CAL, where the calendar to show the particular month and year calendar, we are having the utility called CAL. Okay. So the next command is cat command. Okay. So here in the cat command, it is a short for concatenate. So for the short of the concatenate, so this command is one of the most frequently used command in Linux or Unix. Okay, so it is used for creating files. Since it is used for creating files, it is said to be the most commonly used command. Okay, so this cat command allows to create single or multiple files. Okay, by using this cat command, you can create a single or multiple files. You can view content of the file, you can concatenate files, and you can redirect output in the terminal all files. Okay, by using one command, you can do all these operations. You can create a single file, you can create multiple files, you can view content of the file, and you can concatenate. Means that you can combine two files, and similarly you can do redirection also. Okay. So let's go through one example. Okay, so first let's see how to create a file. Okay, by using this cat command, how to create a file. Okay, so here the syntax for creating the file is So this is your prompt. So dollar prompt. So cat. Okay. So this is the command. So here, if you want to use that, you have to use this greater symbol. Okay. So this greater symbol, cat, greater symbol, new file. Whatever the file you want to create, that file name should be placed here. Okay. So for example, see, this is the I have taken cat greater. I have created a file test one. Okay, so cat greater test one. When I say enter, okay, so when I say enter here, so the cursor will be shown here. Okay, the cursor will be shown here, and it will be waiting for you to enter some text from the keyboard. Okay, so and when you start entering the text on the keyboard, the text will be displayed here. So here I have given the text like this: course is Unix and shell programming. And after that, I have given Unix developed by Ken Thompson. Okay. After completing giving the text, after completion of giving the text, then what you have to do is that you have to press Ctrl plus B. Okay, you have to say Ctrl plus B. Okay, this is like closing the file. Okay, so when you say after giving the entire text, okay. After giving the entire text, after completion of giving the text, so what you have to do is that you have to say Ctrl, you have to press the Ctrl button, and then you have to press the D button. Okay. So when you say Ctrl plus D, so you will be getting this prompt. That means that all the contents are stored in test1 file. Okay. So whatever the contents that you have given, that will be stored in the test1 file. Okay. So it is about the creating the file in the Unix. You can create the file in Unix by using the cat command. Okay, by using the cat command, where you will be giving like cat greater new file. Okay, so where cat greater new file. Okay, so here new file is the name of the file that you want to create. So for example, cat greater test file. Okay. So and when you say enter, the cursor will be going here, and it will be waiting for you to enter the text from the keyboard. Okay. So and then you will be starting to enter the text from the keyboard, like I have entered. This course is Unix and shell programming, and it is developed by Ken Thompson. Okay. So after completing that, after completing of giving the text, you have to say Ctrl plus D. Okay. So when you say Ctrl plus D, the file will be closed and you will be getting the prompt here. Okay. So whatever the text you have given, that will be stored in test1. Okay. So that is about creating a file. Okay. To display the contents of a file. Okay. You have created a file. So like you have created a file by using cat greater test1. Okay. And then you have given like this course is Unix and shell programming developed by Ken Thompson. Okay. Now you want to view the what are the contents of this file. Now I want to know what are the contents that are stored in test1. Okay. For displaying the contents of a file, so again we will be using the cat command only. Okay. So cat file name. Okay. So whatever the file name for which you want to display the text, that file name has to be written. Okay. So here, as an example, see cat test1. Okay. So the file name is test1. So in previous example, we have created a file with test1. Now I want to view the contents. Okay. So I will have to simply say cat test1. So as soon as I say cat test1. So whatever that text you have written, like this course is Unix and shell programming, Unix developed by Ken Thompson, that will be displayed. Okay. So that is the displaying the contents of a file, where you can use the cat command for displaying the contents of a file. Okay. So for displaying the line numbers in a file. Okay. To display the line numbers in a file, we will be using cat minus n file name. Okay. So cat minus n test1. So we have created your test1. So here cat minus n test1. So what happens, it will be whatever the two statements you have written, for the two statements numbers will be given. Okay. So for the two statements, number will be given, statement 1 and statement 2. Okay. Okay. So for display line numbers in a file, if you want to view line numbers, if you want to display the contents in a file with line numbers, okay. If you want to display the contents in a file with line numbers, then you have to say cat. You have to use this option, cat minus n file. So display multiple files at once. Okay, if you want to display multiple files at once, so you have to say like cat file 1 file. Okay, so here I have created two files. Okay, cat greater test 1, where I have written like this is unix and shell programming codes, and again I have created another file test 2. Okay, unix is developed by Ken Thompson. Okay, so I want to display the two files instead of saying two times cat test 1, again cat test 2. Okay, instead of saying cat test 1 and dollar prompts, I am saying cat test 1. So it will be displaying this is unix and shell programming, and again I have to say dollar cat test 2. So again you will be getting the contents. So instead of doing these multiple statements, okay, these two statements can be combined into one, cat test 1 test 2. Okay, so cat test 1 test 2, automatically the two, so this is the contents of first, this is the contents of your test 1, and these are the contents of your test 2. Okay, those two statements will be displayed. So that is like displaying the contents contents of multiple files at once, instead of saying cat test 1, cat test 2, cat test 3. So in a single command line, okay, in a single command line you can do cat test 1, test 2. If you are having another files also, you can do test 3, test 4, test 5. Okay, so all the contents in the file will be displayed one after the other. First the contents of test 1 will be displayed, and after that the contents of test 2 will be displayed, and after that the contents of test 3 will be displayed like that. Okay. So and similarly we are having like appending standard output with redirection. Okay. So here I want to store the data of one file into another file. So here to store the contents of test 5, it will be append. Okay, it is like appending. Okay, so here we have to use these two greater symbols, cat 5 1, two greater symbols 5. Okay, so here I am saying like cat greater than test 5, I have created one file. Okay, I have displayed one, I have again created another file. Okay, so what I am doing is that now I am appending. Okay, so I am appending. So what a test 5 double greater, when I do double greater, so whatever the contents that are stored in test 5, so those contents will be appended to test 6. Okay, so here see the contents of test 6 is, this is test file 6. Okay, to that way I appended your, this is test file 5. Okay, so here to append the contents of the data, to append the contents of one file to another file. Okay, so we have to use two greater symbols. Okay, so it is for appending the contents, appending the contents of one file to the another file. Okay, so that is the about the cat command. Okay, there in the cat command you have seen how to create a file, how to display the contents of a file, and similarly how to display the contents of multiple files, and similarly how to append. Okay, by using the cat command you can append the contents of one file to the another file. Okay, so in today's class we have seen what are the components of Unix, like what is kernel, shell, and what are utilities, and we have seen some basic commands like calendar command, cat command, and various options that are available for the cat.